When you feel taken for granted. When you feel taken for granted. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Breanne. Well, it is cold, cold, cold out on Grandma's porch today, so I'm not out there today, and I didn't do my 5-mile run like I normally do. Y'all know I go for a 5-mile run every day at age 63, but it's too cold for me to do it, even though it's dry and not wet. I just don't want to be out there in that cold weather. Sometimes I do go out in very cold weather and I bundle up and all that, but today's kind of more of a relaxed day, and I think I'm going to take the day off from running. I have an elliptical. Actually, it's in my bedroom. And so I'll probably work out on the elliptical and do my dancing so I get my exercise in. And so I thought I would come on here and talk a little bit about when you feel taken for granted. Now remember, I don't give advice. I don't give suggestions. I just share with you my viewpoints on different issues. And I try to touch topic on all kinds of issues. I now have two channels. Diana Breanne Fairchild is my original one, and Grandma's Porch with Diana Breanne Fairchild. So I do hope you connect on both channels. Well, when you feel taken for granted, I think most everybody has felt that, whether it's justified or not justified. Sometimes we can be overly sensitive, but sometimes what we're feeling is right and correct. Either way, it's our emotions, and we're entitled to our emotions. We're not always entitled to act out with emotions, but we are often entitled to feel what we're feeling. And, you know, it could be that you feel taken for granted in the workplace. You didn't get a promotion. You didn't get that raise. And everybody else got the raise. And yet you're doing an exceptional job. It could be that you feel taken for granted at home by your family, your friends, your relatives. Maybe you're the one that does all the cooking all the time and no one helps out. It's just you, you, you. Well, in my life, I've had a few episodes where I felt taken for granted. And any time that that ever happened in my life, I recognized it. And I dealt with it in a very positive way. I remember someone who, whenever they felt taken for granted, they would blow up. You know, they would just start cussing and carrying on and all that. And that's usually, that doesn't achieve anything in my opinion. And only makes a fool of that person. So the way I deal with it is I just stop what everyone else is taking for granted. So for example, if I was in a situation where I was always doing all the cooking and no one else was helping out, I would probably, for me personally, stop doing the cooking. And I just wouldn't make excuses about it. I wouldn't justify it. I would just say, I'm not doing it this year. You know, I'm gonna let someone else do it, take their turn. And people may say, oh, well, that's terrible. You always do the cooking. And well, now we kind of miss your cooking. Well, let someone else take the turn this year. And so I think that often when we pull in the rug, sometimes just a little bit, as Grandma would say, pull in the rug. And when we pull in the rug a little bit, often people take notice. Sometimes we have to pull it in a little bit more for them to really take notice. And some people don't take it seriously in the beginning. And so it depends on what we're talking about. It depends on the relationship. It depends on the people, of course. You know, we want to do everything right. And it's got to be the right thing. I mean, if I pull in the rug at work, then I may get fired because, you know, it just may be the way it is. I may have to be very careful and thoughtful in how I approach feeling taken for granted. Maybe I'll express it to my boss. I'll say, hey, everybody else got a raise. Can you explain to me, please, why I didn't get a raise? And maybe they'll say, oh, I just forgot. I'm sorry. I overlooked it. I didn't realize it. And then it's all resolved. Or it could be that they say, well, I didn't think you did that great of a job. And then you can ask them how you can improve so that you can get the raise. And ask them, if I improve in these areas, will I get the raise? So sometimes there can be miscommunication there too as well. And so I think it's important for us to acknowledge our emotions, not deny our emotions, but be very thoughtful in how we express our emotions. And so I think everyone has dealt with that issue of feeling taken for granted. And often the sooner we deal with that issue and we deal with our feelings about it and express it in the right way, often the better. From my house to yours, may God bless you, and I hope to talk to you soon again. From Grandma's Porch, I hope you like, share, subscribe to both of my channels, and I will talk to you soon again. Bye-bye. To relax.